Welcome to the channel. Today is the second part of Getting Your RTSP Cameras in Home Assistant series. I'll put part one in the pop-up above. Today we'll be looking at how you can improve on the latency of your RTSP cameras. That's another way of saying how can you display your view from your camera more quickly. We'll be doing this with add-ons that are available to all Home Assistant OS and supervised installs. There are two such add-ons that we'll use, which are WebRTC and GoToRTC. We'll be installing both and having a race against each other and keeping the winner. WebRTC is a free open source project that provides web browsers and mobile applications with real-time communication via a simple API. It allows audio and video communications to work inside web pages by allowing direct peer-to-peer communications, eliminating the need to install plugins or download native apps. On the other hand, Web2RTC is a versatile camera streaming application that supports various protocols, including RTSP, RTMP, and even Web2RTC, amongst many others. It's designed for streaming video from different sources, including cameras, USB devices, and other streams. But we'll let the performance make the decision for us. Now, you might already be happy with the latency of your camera before installing the add-ons, and if that's the case, then this might just be for fun, but I think you'll be surprised by the performance increases. So let's dive on in and shift our camera into hyperdrive. Let's install WebRTC first. Navigate to Settings, Add-ons, press the blue Add-on Store button in the bottom right-hand corner, press the three dots in the top right-hand corner, and select Repositories. Now copy the repository from the description for WebRTC and paste into the Add field. Now press Add. Once added, you can now close this screen. Now remember to refresh your screen. Now search for WebRTC. Select the RTSP to web-webRTC. Now press Install. Now turn on Watchdog and press Start. Confirm the add-on has started with the green dot in the top right-hand corner. To view the WebRTC dashboard, either press the Open Web UI or navigate to http://homeassistant.local:8083. Once the dashboard is displayed, press the Add Stream in the top right-hand corner. Name your stream, in my case, Study Camera. Enter the stream URL, which came from the Ewe Link app that we used in the generic camera integration in part 1. Select your stream type. On demand is when you press play, whereas persistent is continually getting the video stream from your camera. I would recommend using the persistent connection, as this will yield the best performance. Press save stream. Confirm by pressing OK. Navigate to the dashboard in the top left-hand corner. You'll be given the option to stream in four different streaming formats. I won't go into the details, but each have their pros and cons around compression, resolution, and latency. We are only interested in the WebRTC, but it's fun to see the differences between each. Press All. Now let's do a quick test. I'll put my hand in front of the camera and we can see the relative latency. As you can see, WebRTC is sub 1 second, with the others lagging behind. Now let's install GoToRTC so that we can compare against WebRTC. Navigate to Settings, Add-ons, press the blue Add-on Store button in the bottom right-hand corner. Press the three dots in the top right-hand corner. Select Repositories. Copy the repository from the description below for GoToRTC and paste into the Add field. Press Add. Confirm that the repository has been added. And now close. Remember to refresh your browser. Now search for and select GoToRTC. Press Install. Now turn on the watchdog and show in sidebar. And press Start. Confirm that the add-on has started by the green dot in the top right-hand corner. To view the GoToRTC dashboard, either press the Open Web UI or select in the sidebar menu. Once again, we'll add the Study Camera stream. Select Add in the top menus. Now select Home Assistant. You will now see the Study Camera stream that has been configured previously through the generic camera integration. Copy the RTSP stream URL in the Location field. Now press Configure in the top menu. Here we need to enable the stream. Under Stream, insert a line feed. Now insert two spaces, then the name of your stream, in my case, Study Camera, followed by a colon. Now insert another line feed. Again, insert two spaces, type a dash, then a space, Then paste your RTSP stream URL. Now press Save and Restart, and confirm with OK. Now press Streams in the top menu. Your camera stream will now show up. To view your camera stream, press Stream in the Commands column. You should now see your camera stream that has been fed through GoToRTC. Now let's test the performance of WebRTC and GoToRTC. Now let the race begin. I'll position the WebRTC on the left-hand side and the GoToRTC on the right-hand side. Now I'll put my hand into the shot and see who wins. And the winner is WebRTC with a commanding lead, followed very shortly afterwards by GoToRTC and MSC a close third, with HLSLL off the pace in fourth and HLS coming in a disappointing fifth. So WebRTC wins by a close nose and will be my choice for direct streams. Now, although we've had some fun here and proven that WebRTC is the quickest stream optimizer, it's not a clear-cut decision. GoToRTC is vastly superior to WebRTC in many areas. For instance, if you are running Frigate, then GoToRTC is now fully integrated and included in the installation. This is the preferred optimization add-on if you're using Frigate. So for this alone, if you're thinking about using Frigate, I would use GoToRTC. I'm relatively new to RTSP streaming and still learning. If you'd like more details on GoToRTC and Frigate, I recommend watching a video from Mostly Chris, who goes into a lot more detail. I'll put a link to his video in the description below. But for this simple installation, WebRTC is my choice, well, for the moment at least. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you want to see more content like this, then consider liking the video, subscribing, and becoming a member of the channel. And if I've helped you get this up and running and optimized, then maybe a super thanks or PayPal donation. It's really appreciated. Until the next one, I hope your latency is low and your resolution is high.